Hello there, my fellow druids and lovers of life magic, and welcome back to another episode on Warhammer Fantasy Lore. Today's video is gonna be part 2 from our coverage on the so-called Jade Order. We already talked about who these guys are and what they do, so today we will dive a bit more into the college building itself and the apprentices of their order. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Jade College is the focus and ideological center of the Magisters studying the Green Wind of Giran and the Lore of Life. It is surrounded by a great wall, unbroken by any windows or towers. This wall is over 60 feet high and taller than any of the surrounding buildings. It is built out of brick, and the outer face is glazed green, with a college symbol set into every block, a spiral, a triskele, or an oak leaf. The wall is roughly circular, but actually forms the first ring of a clockwise spiral, about 200 yards around. Thus, at one point, the face of the wall steps 20 feet backwards. The only entrance to the college is located there, a simple oaken door set in the base of the wall. The door is guarded at all times by 4 heavily armed and armored warriors, actually chosen to represent the different stages of life. One of them is young, another in his prime, the third in middle age, and the fourth old. Despite their appearance, they are all highly skilled and capable fighters, prodigies or veterans of the arts of combat and war. If they sound the alarm, the Magisters inside will come to their aid immediately. The Magisters of the Order are allowed to enter the college without any kind of question, and can even take one or two friends. A Magister trying to take a large group of people inside would be asked for a reason, but pretty much any reason given would suffice. Everyone else will need to demonstrate that they have a proper business inside the college. As with many colleges, a request to meet a particular Magister leads the guard to send a messenger to see if that Magister is actually around and wants to see them. If he does, he will come to meet them at a gate. People are not allowed to wander inside the college on a whim. Those which are allowed into the building find that the spiral continues on the inside. On their left, the inner face of the wall is lined with buttresses, and ivy and other climbing plants grow all over it. To their right, a line of trees and shrubs forms an almost natural-looking wall. The path itself is grassed over. As the visitors walk around the path, they find that the stench of the city is replaced by the clean scent of nature, and the sound of wind in the trees and the distant flow of water replace the noise of human habitation. Perceptive visitors might realize there are few animal sounds within this strange oasis, and even more perceptive visitors would realize that the outer wall is still to their left, so they are actually no further from the city than they were immediately after passing through the gate. Nevertheless, it sounds and smells a lot further away. After just a single circuit, the trees and the shrubs replace the wall on the left, and the right hand of the spiral becomes even more varied. Sometimes trees and shrubs, sometimes patterns of stones, sometimes pools and streams of water. The ground rises in small artificial hills, creating constantly varying scenery recalling that of various parts of the Empire. The Jade College seems to be substantially bigger on the inside than on the outside, and it can take well over an hour to walk to the center following the path. However, once you are past of the first inner circuit, it is possible to take a shortcut, which will lead to the grove of trees forming the heart of the college. Those trees, predominantly oaks, with a few ash, yew, birch, and chestnut, have been shaped by the magic and the patience of the Magisters into a living hall. The branches and the leaves form walls and floors, and at the center of the grove, a circle of mighty oaks forms the walls and pillars of a great domed chamber, where the college gathers when it must take counsel together. In the center of this circle of oaks is a huge waystone, which is fairly green-tinted, carved with complex swirling patterns. Around this are many smaller rooms, which are used by the members of the college when they actually choose to stay here. The Jade College has very few permanent residents, and even they change their rooms very frequently, so most of the rooms are the same, furnished with carefully shaped branches and upholstered with moss. There are rooms where rainwater flows constantly down branches, pooling briefly in a bowl formed of ivy leaves before flowing away. In others, trees and vines twist through the wall, bearing fruits and nuts at all times of the year. The college has a library where scrolls of its lore are cradled in its own niches in the trunk of an enormous tree, reached by walking up sturdy branches. Yet the majority of the college's lore is carved in runic and symbolic form upon vast oak tree trunks, and on standing stones within the college's confines. Much of the interior of the Jade College is devoid of any animal life, and there are few magisters there at any time, especially in summer or winter. However, only a foolish visitor seeks to start any violence within the Jade College, because the trees and the vines are said to come alive, and they can capture or restrain any aggressive interloper. The Jade Magisters on business in Aldorf will spend much of their time in the college building, finding it more congenial than the city streets. As such, a visitor may bump into a magister while walking in the college gardens. Even in the rainy weather, there are paths sheltered by the trees for those that know where to look. It is very difficult to break into the Jade College, not that anyone other than the most insane cultist or foolish thief would ever even try. Anyone spotted climbing the high wall will probably be spotted by the city watch. Also, the plants in the college are more aware than normal shrubbery, and they will notice any intruder. However, they only pass this information to the magisters if they should think to ask, which means if a visitor can come and go without raising suspicion, he would be relatively safe. If the magisters do investigate, however, a full description is easily available from the plants and trees that the visitor hid behind. If the interloper is discovered by a magister, he will find himself spending his last days as a bush or an interestingly shaped hedge. The majority of the apprentices of the Jade College tend to be the offspring of existing magisters, forming, overall, a sort of isolated druidic caste. However, the rural hedge wizards with a particular affinity for the magic of growth and fertility will often attract the order of life to them. Since money is not a consideration for the Jade College, they never worry about how much apprentices can actually pay them. The land supplies them with all they need, and money has little to no value. However, initiates are bound to the order by oaths involving wild magic, and the shedding of blood under the light of the Chaos Moon, so only the truly committed are accepted into the Order of Life. Teaching the lore of life is affected by the seasonal flow of Giran. From the first new moon after the autumn equinox until the winter solstice, the studies of Giran's apprentices and magisters concentrate more upon the theory and lore of the Order, because at this time Giran's power is relatively weak. The Order is most active from when the moon Manslieb is first full, in the spring equinox, and continues for two periods of the moon's waxing and waning. This is the Order's most active period, and apprentices are plunged into a day and night learning frenzy, where spells are taught via oral traditions of the Order and practices. At the end of the session, all the Order's druidic communities hold great festivities within certain groves and henges. During this celebration, apprentices who have become adept enough to be accepted as senior apprentices are given a copper sickle, and those that become journeyman wizards are given a sickle of pure silver as symbols of their status. This is always done unexpectedly, and none of the apprentices know who or when they will get their sickle, if at all. There is no examination whatsoever. The senior druids of any community meet to discuss which of the candidates are ready. During the night, while the candidates are involved in semi-ritualized dances and singing, a master will suddenly appear dressed as the Green Man or the Earth Mother, and will hand a sickle to the successful apprentices. At the end of the festival, the various students leave to practice their magic and journey over the summer. Those wanting to become full magisters of the Order must travel to Aldorf by the summer equinox, where he or she will be tested by the Lord Magisters, or High Druids, who gather there for their yearly assembly. Those that pass the stringent and often dangerous tasks of the High Druids will be given a gold sickle, and will be accepted as a full Magister of the Order of Life. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you on the Druids of the Jade Order for today. And with this, we also conclude our coverage of the third College of Magic so far. Still plenty to go in the form of five others. Now, are you a fan of these folks and their life magic? Would you like to be a member of the Jade College? Let us know why in case you do, or why not in case you don't. All in the comments below. Was the episode informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. You can also click the bell notification icon to stay more up to date. Thanks a lot for watching to the end, and I wish you all an awesome and peaceful day. Sigmar's blessings be upon you.